Right. You know that magnetic fields, it moves in different directions. This time, it is important for us to know how to calculate the force that is connected to the wire with respect to the direction. So the formula for force says, let's start with that one. Force equals to I, L, which is the length of the wire. If the wire is 2 meters, 3 meters, 4 meters, that's the length of the wire you need to get. That's the current of the wire. And then that's the magnetic field of the wire. And here comes the part now, which you really need to know. The sine of theta. That is the angle between the magnetic field and the current. So now you need to understand that. Let's say the magnetic field is coming on a different direction now. Let me put the magnetic field in red so we can see it. Say this is our magnetic field, right? It's going in that direction. And remember, your current on the wire, let's put it in that direction. Do you see that the current is going straight upwards, it's going to the north, right? While the magnetic field is going on east. See what's going on there? So now they are perpendicular to each other. So which means here the angle between the current and the magnetic field is 90. Do you see what's going on there? So which means for a force, they are going to say force is equals to you put in the current that is given to you, the length of the wire that is given to you there, the size of the magnetic field there, and you're going to say the sine of 90, which is basically one. So which means when current is perpendicular to the magnetic field, we can ignore the sine of theta. So that's why you see on your guide, there is a formula like this and there is a formula like this. You can only use this if current is perpendicular to the magnetic field. If the angle in between the current and the magnetic field is 90, because the sine of 90 is 1. Let's go to the second part now of the wire. So let's say now, differently now, they decide to put the magnetic field. Okay, let me put it like this. They decide to put the current in this direction and it has a certain angle, right? And the magnetic field still going in that direction, right? So this is my current going in a different direction and the angle between the current and the magnetic field, it changes now. It becomes 30 or 40 something. It's very important for you to know. If you be able to determine the angle between these two, once you determine the angle in between these two, then you get your size of the current, length, magnetic field, and the angle in between the two, which is very important. What will happen, let's say the current is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So this is my magnetic field. They are all perpendicular. By perpendicular, which means there is no angle in between them. The angle in between the current and the magnetic field will be equal to what? Will be equal to zero. Do you see that, right? So if it is equal to zero, what is the sine of zero? The sine of zero is zero. So which means once the current and the magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, the force will be equal to zero. Make sure that you understand that concept. It's very important for you to get it. So now we are done with this part. All right. Now let's focus on this. Let's say you are given a rectangular wire, and in this rectangular wire there is current moving in it, right? So let's say the current that is moving in the wire is going in this direction. Definitely sure it's going to come up there, and it's going to come in there and also come down there, right? And they told us that the direction of the magnetic field here, let me put it on X values, right? Let me use a different color there so that we can see it. Let me use black. So this is the direction of the magnetic field. If you see something like this, still the direction of the magnetic field. But here it's telling you that the direction of the magnetic field is going into the page, right? And I told you something about the right-hand rule, very important. I say to you about the right-hand rule. The right-hand rule says the tip of your fingers are your magnetic field, right? So where is the magnetic field going? That is going into the page. Do you see that, right? So now let's start by doing this wire only. Let's take as if you are cutting this wire only, and when we cut it, it's going to be something like this. You see that, right? When you cut it off, it shows you that the current is going there, right? And still the magnetic field is going where? Inside the page. I'm just taking this part of the wire just to make you understand the concept. So which means, in other words, you see what's going on? The current is going up there, right? So we want to see the force in the actually on the direction of this thing. So which means when you want to determine the force, right, it's magnetic field going in there. Your thumb is the direction of the current, Remember, I said your thumb is the direction of the current, that your fingers are the direction of the magnetic field. This is the direction of the current. See, so which means if the magnetic field is going into the page and the current is going away, upwards, the force is your palm, right? Which means this wire will experience a force going in that direction, which means there will be a force that is experienced here, and the force goes in that direction. We want to see where this loop, right now, this rectangular shaped wire is going to experience a force going in which direction. We want to know the direction of the force or that will be experienced by this wire. So when we come on this part, you see that the current is coming down here. So let's do the same thing again. But this time, let's take the current way downwards. Same thing, but we're just taking the current in a different direction. So now, look at that. The magnetic field, where is it going? The magnetic field, the tip of my fingers, is going into the page because these are the axes. They're going into the page. But where is the current going? The current is going where? It's going downwards. And I told you that your force is the direction of the palm of your hands. Where is the direction of the palm facing? Is facing in that direction, which means now it will experience the same force because this is the same magnetic field throughout going in that direction. Do you see that now? Which means this part will experience a force now going in which direction? In that direction. But do you see that the force in this direction and in that direction, they will cancel each other because the magnetic field throughout is equal, right? But this part will not experience any force. Why? Because there's no magnetic field lines. So the magnetic field lines are only put up to only half of this rectangular shape, not the full one, which means here there's no force at all that is being experienced, right? Now see that there is no force at all. But when we come down here, look at that, we are going to redraw this same wire. Then we are cutting only this piece and we're putting the direction of the current, and now let's put all the magnetic field there. And then let's try and see where is the force going to be experienced. Now look at this. The current is going, the thumb represents the current, my fingers represent the magnetic field, and the axes are telling me that the magnetic field is going into the page. So when it enters into the page, you see that? Where is my palm facing? My palm is facing downwards, which means the force that will be experienced here is going where? Is going downwards. Do you see what's going on? So which means the force that will be experienced by this portion of the wire will be what? Will be going downwards. Since there is no force up there, it will force the whole thing to move, the whole rectangular wire to move downwards, and then which means the direction of this rectangular wire will move down there, and then that's how you determine the direction of the force. Right, remember now that the magnetic field for the wire, the formula is given by B. Let me call this B1, right? I can call it anything that is as B, mu 0 multiplied by I divided by 2 pi r. So now we have this formula, right? But when they say calculate for the force, right? The formula for force, remember there is two wires. If it is force between, the formula for force is going to be F is equals to what? Is equals to L, is equals to the current multiplied by the length multiplied by B. But if it is two wires, we have to include the second wire. Let me call this wire 1, let me call this B2. Let's say this is the magnetic field. Remember, the magnetic field, if it is experienced here, is the same magnetic field that will be experienced by all the wires. So the magnetic field will be the same there. So we can confidently say the magnetic field felt by wire 1 is the same magnetic field also felt by what? By wire 2. So this one is going to be current 2. Do you see that? So now, which means in other words, so the magnetic field will be the same throughout. So which means I1 plus L, which is the length of the wire, B, now I'm going to put everything here. You see that? Which is going to be what? Mu 0 I2 divided by 2 pi R. So now we get the formula by what? By the force, right? Experienced by force when there are two or more wires, right? So let's go to the question that has been given to us in the tutorial card number 2.9. They say to us, we must calculate the magnitude of the net force that is given of this loop, that is being experienced by this loop. So one thing you need to get there is that we are already given the distance, right? They say the distance from here to that side is 1.2 meters, which is the distance from the first wire to the second part. And they told us that the distance of the square here, which is 1 meter, which means the distance that begins from here, let's start by dealing with the distances before we go any further. Distance from there to there will be that 1 meter minus 1.2 meter will get that is going to be 0.2 meters. Now, remember, for us to get the net force, we used to use that formula. So the distance from this wire, from here to the other part of the wire, still remember, is going to be the same distance that is there, which is 1.2 meters. So which means we are going to use this distance when you are taking this wire to that wire, and we are going to use this distance when you are taking this wire to the second part of the wire. But now, the force that will be experienced will only be the force on this part of the wires only. Why did I say that? If the magnetic field is not given to you, you must know that the magnetic field is always what? Going in that direction, perpendicular. That's if it is not given to you. In this case, they didn't mention anything about the magnetic field, so it is safe to put it in that direction. But look in the direction of the magnetic field. You see that? It is perpendicular to these two. What did I say about the force? The force experienced by the line that is perpendicular with the magnetic field. There will be no force here that is being experienced. That's number one. We get something that is better. So there will be no force here. And also, there's no force also that will be experienced here. So there will be no force that is being experienced here, and also no force that is experienced here. Reason why, it is because the magnetic field is perpendicular to it. And remember, that formula that I showed you is going to be the sign of zero, which means there's no force here, no force here. But there will be force here, definitely, and there will also be some force that is being experienced also on this part. So now, let's go to our formula for force and try and get what's really going on. We have already come to conclusion. Remember, F net will be the force experienced by this wire to this wire. And if they are going on the same direction, it will have a positive what? A positive sign. But if they are going on the negative direction, it's going to be what? You see, this one is going up, but this one is going down. So if they are going on the opposite direction, then the force that will be our final product there will be negative. So my F net there will be force experienced by wire one to this one, right now. Let's start with this one to this one. We already have the distance. So what is the formula there? The formula there, let me call the current of that first wire and the current multiplied by the current of the second wire multiplied by length multiplied by mu, which is this one, divided by 2 pi r. So what's the distance in between them? We already have the distance, right? We already have the current of the first wire. We already have the current of the second wire. We already have the distance there. And we already have the length. Remember, what is the length there? The length is 1 meter, because all of them will be 1 meter. So this one, the reason why they didn't give us the length for it is because we need to consider the force that is being experienced by the square. So we are focusing on the length of the square, right? And then this is what we have. So now the second one here, also to the square, do you see what's going on there? It's going down. They're going in opposite direction, which means it's going to be minus again. Then I'm going to put same thing, I1 multiplied by I2, length mu0 divided by 2 pi r. And remember, the difference here will be the what? The radiuses. Everything will be more or less the same. Do you get what's going on there? So now the distance of the first wire to the second wire will be what? 0.2 meters. So you are going to put our, let's say, okay, let me write it perfectly. So it's going to be something like this. So it's going to be F net equals to, what is the first current there? It's going to be 10 times 2 multiplied by the length, which is multiplied by 1 mu 0, which is the same thing as, let me just write, so to save space, let me write it as mu 0, which is, remember, 4 pi times 10 to the power negative 7. So where there's mu 0, just put 4 pi times 10 to the power negative 7. Then you divide it by 2 pi. The distance there for the first wire there is going to be 0.2. Remember, we've already calculated it. You come to the second one again, it's going to be 10 times 2 times the length, which is 1, multiplied by mu 0, divided by 2 pi. Remember, my r this time is a distance from there to this other part, which is what? 1.2. And if you put that in a calculator and you calculate your F net, it's going to give you that number that you get there, which is 1.6. 7 times 10 to the power, negative 5. And because it's force, the answer must be in newtons. So that's how you calculate the force of this thing. Let's come and answer the next question. Still remember there, right? The current, they're still the same, and the current, they're still the same. Look at what is going on here. Look at the radius. The bigger the radius, right? The bigger the radius, what will happen to the force? The force will be what? Will be low, because once you increase the radius, you are decreasing the what? The force. It's more like I put a, okay, if I put this in a calculator and I divide by a 20 here, like a bigger distance, the number will be smaller than when I'm dividing it by a 2, right? Which means, you see the distance between here and here is smaller, right? That will make my force to be bigger. And the distance between here and here is bigger. That will make my force to be what? To be smaller. So, which means the force will be greater here. And this force will be able to pull this loop towards the wire. That's what the answer of the, that's the direction of the wire there.